Slavery was a pervasive part of Roman society, and it was an integral part of the economy. Slaves performed a variety of jobs, ranging from household tasks, tutoring, labor, to even administrative roles. Under Roman law, slaves were considered property or chattel, not persons. This meant they were the legal equivalent of inanimate objects, which had profound implications for their legal and social status. Because slaves were considered property, they could be bought, sold, or inherited just like any other piece of property. They could also be given as gifts or used as payment for a debt. Slaves had no legal rights or protections. They couldn't own property, enter into contracts, or bring lawsuits. They were also not protected against physical abuse or mistreatment by their masters. The owner of a slave had almost complete control over their life. The master could decide where the slave would live, what kind of work they would do, whether they could marry, and even whether they would live or die. The slaves were at the complete mercy of their owners. In ancient Rome, there was a legal principle of collective responsibility when it came to slaves. According to this principle, if a slave killed their master, all the slaves that belonged to that master and lived under the same roof were to be executed, even if they had no involvement in the crime. The purpose of this harsh law was to serve as a deterrent. It was intended to discourage slaves from murdering their masters by establishing severe consequences that would impact not only the guilty individual, but all those around them as well. By doing this, the law also aimed to encourage slaves to police each other in order to prevent such an act from occurring. This principle of collective responsibility was vividly demonstrated in the case of Lucius Pedanius Secundus, a Roman senator who was murdered by one of his slaves in 61 AD, under the reign of Nero. All of the slaves in the household, men, women, and even children, amounting to roughly 400 people, were executed as a form of collective punishment. The execution of Pedanius Secundus's household caused significant controversy in Rome. There was an outcry from the populace, and some members of the Senate attempted to intervene and stop the mass execution. However, others argued that the law must be upheld to prevent further slave rebellions. Despite the protests, the executions went ahead. Despite the lack of rights, slaves could be freed by their masters, a process known as manumission. Once manumitted, a slave became a freedman and gained certain rights, although they were still not on the same level as freeborn Roman citizens. History has preserved few names of freedmen, one of the best known being Pythagoras, who was known as one of the close associates of the Emperor Nero, and even became his wife in a symbolic, though controversial, marriage. There are several notable historical figures who were born as slaves, but later became freedmen. Epictetus was a Greek Stoic philosopher. He was born a slave in Hierapolis, Phrygia, present-day Pamukkale, Turkey, and lived in Rome until his banishment, when he went to Nicopolis in northwestern Greece to open a school of philosophy. Horace or Quintus Horatius Flaccus was one of the leading Roman lyric poets during the time of Augustus. His father was likely a slave who was given his freedom by his master, and Horace was thus freeborn. He's known for his odes, epistles, and satires. Phaedrus was a Roman fabulist, born in Macedonia and brought to Rome as a slave. He was later given his freedom by Augustus. Phaedrus is recognized as the first writer to Latinize entire books of fables, using the iambic meter Greek model. Publius Cyrus was a Latin writer best known for his Sententia. He was a Syrian who was brought as a slave to Italy, but by his wit and talent, he won the favor of his master, who freed and educated him. Marcus Antonius Felix was the Roman procurator, governor, of Idaea province, which is now Israel, Palestine, and parts of Jordan, Lebanon, and Syria, under the Emperor Claudius. He served from around 52 to 60 AD. His period of governance was marked by internal feuds and disturbances, which he handled with severity. Felix was originally a slave, then was freed by Antonia Minor, who was the mother of the Emperor Claudius and the grandmother of Emperor Nero. This made Felix a freedman of the imperial household, a status that came with certain privileges. As procurator, Felix is most known for his interactions with the nascent Christian community. According to the Acts of the Apostles in the New Testament, the Apostle Paul was arrested in Jerusalem and brought before Felix for trial. He was held in custody by Felix for 2 years before being transferred to Rome. The most common source of slaves was warfare. When Roman forces conquered a territory, they often enslaved a portion of the defeated population. This practice was not unique to Rome. Many ancient societies did the same. The more the empire expanded, the more slaves were brought to Rome. Pirates and bandits operating in the Mediterranean often captured people to sell as slaves. In some instances, entire towns and settlements were raided for the purpose of capturing slaves. The Romans also imported slaves from outside their borders through trade. Slaves were traded as goods on a large scale, especially from areas such as Africa, Britain, and the East. Children of slaves, known as vernae, were automatically slaves themselves. This was another common source of slaves. In earlier times, Roman citizens could be forced into slavery or nexum due to unpaid debts. However, the Lex Potelia Papyria law, passed in 326 BC, abolished this form of slavery for Roman citizens. While slaves in ancient Rome were largely oppressed and had limited rights, they didn't remain passive in the face of their oppression. The most famous slave revolt was the Third Servile War, often known as the Spartacus Revolt. Spartacus was a Thracian gladiator who, along with about 70 followers, escaped from a gladiator school in Capua. They defeated several Roman armies and attracted thousands of slaves to their cause, creating a major crisis for the Roman Republic. Despite their initial successes, the revolt was eventually crushed by the forces of Marcus Licinius Crassus. Spartacus was killed in battle, and surviving rebels were crucified along the Appian Way as a warning to other slaves. Eumus was a Syrian slave who became one of the leaders of the First Servile War, a major slave uprising against the Roman Republic. He was known for his charismatic personality and his claimed ability to perform miracles and predict the future. Eumus became a prominent leader during the First Servile War, which took place in Sicily from 135 to 132 BC. It's said that he was initially asked by his fellow slaves to be the leader of the revolt because of his charisma and supposed supernatural abilities. After the revolt began, Eumus took the name Antiochus after the famous Hellenistic kings, and he claimed to be a prophet of the Syrian goddess Atargatis. He'd established himself as king and led an army that supposedly grew to around 70,000 slaves. Despite some initial successes, Eumus' forces were eventually defeated by the Roman army. According to historical accounts, Eumus was captured and imprisoned by the Romans, where he reportedly died. Salvius, who adopted the name Tryphon after a Seleucid ruler, was a slave who became a significant figure during the Second Servile War, a major slave uprising in Sicily that took place between 104 and 100 BC. Salvius was initially a slave of a certain Epicrates and reportedly worked as a cattle herder. He was described as being very eloquent and had a strong physique, which helped him gain the respect and loyalty of his fellow slaves. When the slave rebellion broke out in Sicily, he emerged as one of the leaders. The rebellion started as a result of the harsh conditions faced by slaves in Sicily, particularly those working in the mines and on large estates. Following a series of victories against local forces and other successes, Salvius was proclaimed king and took the name Tryphon, from Diodotus Tryphon, a Seleucid ruler who had himself risen from obscure origins. Under Tryphon's leadership, the rebels successfully held out against Roman forces for several years. They managed to control large parts of Sicily, even minting their own coins. However, the rebellion was ultimately suppressed by the Roman general Manius Aquilius. These revolts, while ultimately unsuccessful, represent significant challenges to the Roman social order. They highlight the inherent tensions and contradictions within the system of slavery in ancient Rome. Despite the brutal punishments meted out to those who rebelled, slaves were not simply passive victims, but often sought to resist their enslavement.